Get ready to match the stars. Don Galloway, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, the Barnaby Jones, Lee Merriweather, Bill Daly, and Patty Deutsch as we play the star-studded Big Bunny Match Game PM. And now, here's the star of Match Game PM, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, John.
Thank you, friend.
Very kind to join us here on Match Game PM. We're going to have a good time because the loonies are out.
Yes. Where?
No, here they are. They're beautiful loonies here. Now let's say hello to our two civilians here, Rick Yoder and Denise Walters. We welcome both of you. We'd like to find out a little bit about each of you. Let's begin with you, Denise.
Well, I'm a high school teacher, and I teach physical education, and the most important thing is I'm a newlywed 2 weeks.
Oh. It was kind of you to take the time out to come and visit us here.
This is the only honeymoon I got.
Oh, it is? Well, good luck to you, Denise, here. Rick, what do you got to say about yourself?
I'm from Ames, Iowa.
Aren't we all? Don't give your right name either. I can see Rick Yoder is not your real name, is it?
Oh, sure it is.
Oh, it is?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, and I'm a foreman for a railroad contractor.
No kidding. Sounds like an interesting job.
It's a lot of fun.
Yeah. Make any money?
Nope.
Give him a raise. Whoever, give this fellow a raise. He deserves it. Listen, here on the PM game, each of you will have three opportunities to match as many of those as you possibly can. Now, the one who's done that most often at the end of the third round will be the winner, and that person will go on to play the Big Money Super Match, which can pay off over $20,000. Are you ready for that? We're ready here now. Denise, A or B?
B, please.
B it is. We're off and running. Mm-hmm. The dentist said to Henrietta, boy, this is a deep cavity. The tip of my drill just came out of your blank. Well, the dentist is drilling, you see. You're Henrietta.
Yeah.
I'm the dentist.
You're the dentist.
I got the drill going in here. Boy, this is a deep cavity. The tip of my drill just came out of your blank.
I got it.
Okay.
Oh, that's terrible.
The dentist said to Henrietta, boy, there's a deep cavity. The tip of my drill just came out of your blank.
Neck.
Yes. No humor in that. A sanguinary sight, to be sure. Don?
Back in Kentucky in high school, we used to say, hey, I went all the way down to the toe.
Oh, ho! That was some long drill, Don. What do you got here?
Back in Portland, Maine, we used to say the man who called it necking was a poor judge of distance. I said navel.
Navel. A good response.
Left bun.
Left bun.
Left bun.
Depends on which angle.
Well, there you see.
Now, if I was going down this way and the drilling and the zing,
right?
Be very
right
careful,
oh,
Mr. Rayburn.
Right. Oh, that's your right.
Yes.
Well, you see, I'm dyslexic.
Well, mine went in this way, you see.
Yes.
And came out my left bobby.
Oh, left bobby.
Uh-huh. I can't spell. Oh, I think that's terrible.
Yes. I think it's a rather amusing answer. Why is that?
But it hurts.
It hurts, yes, to think about it even. Why are you holding your breath?
Has anybody got a picture of me in my good vest and my good suit?
God, you...
Can I take this off?
Yes. Feel
work.
Better, right?
I said the tip of your right bun. No, the tip of your toe is what I put there,
toes.
And I got a food for that also.
Yeah. Two toes so far.
Two toes
don't make a foot.
No,
two toes
that's
so
right.
Far.
All right, Nick, this is a deep cavity. The tip of my drill just came out of your...
Shoulder bag.
All right. Okay. Now, Rick, we have one of equal difficulty for you. Ames, Iowa.
That's right. I'll just take my vest off.
You can take it off?
Yeah, take my vest.
Why is that? You don't
know, because it's tight and it holds all the fat in. It's
right.
Wait, I think I'll take my pants off. This
no,
is
no, 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 no.
Cut.
Enough.
Yeah.
Here,
okay.
Very chic. Yes. As a matter of fact, it
does harmonize.
Yes.
Oh, my God.
Here we go.
So good to breathe.
Now listen to this, Rick. Weird Wanda is really weird.
How weird!
I gotta tell you. In high school, she was voted most likely to marry a blank. That's how weird she was. Weird Wanda's really weird. In high school, she was voted most likely to marry a blank. Okay. Weird Wanda's really weird, Rick. In high school, she was voted most likely to marry a blank.
A dog.
Okay. Right. That's a very good answer you gave.
A wonderful answer.
Yeah. Did you hear he said dog?
Dog, D-O-G, dog.
That's not weird.
Yes,
I know
it
a
is.
Lot of people who've married dogs.
Oh. What do you have to say about this, Don?
I went for the ever-popular orangutan.
Orangutan! Okay.
I went from the seldom seen game show MC.
Nothing funny about that.
Could be Peter Marshall.
A
Alan
tasteless,
Lund.
Libelous answer if I've ever heard of one. Okay.
I said bigamist.
A bigamist. She's voted most likely to marry a bigamist. Okay. All right. What do you got to say about Weird Wanda, who's voted most likely to marry a...
A chimpanzee.
A chimp. Okay. Now, we're looking for a dog here.
Let me put my vest back on. I think I'm a little funny with that vest.
Yeah.
I'm sorry about that. I went for the bad incest joke. I said, marry your brother, which is very...
Yeah. Mary voted most what? Likely to marry her brother. Yeah. Boom, he's going to eat the whole thing and get sick on the show, and we're going to have to stop the
I just ate my brother.
All right. Speaking of weirdos, you've noticed she no longer has bangs.
She's bangless.
Now, did you cut it or did they just comb it back?
It's glued to the top of my head.
Oh, it is glued.
Yes.
And you're
if
testing
it. If I take
it.
Off this barrette,
yeah.
It looks like I've been in the electric chair.
Uh-huh.
Actually, I grew her old bangs on my face. That's what this
yes.
is.
That's
what
that
Thank
is.
You for
yeah.
your
bangs. Okay.
You're quite well, any time.
Time for the answer. She voted most likely to marry a...
Nixon supporter.
Ah!
That's weird.
Oh, good. So what do we have up to round one? Round one questions are very tough, and so don't worry about the fact that neither one of you scored, but we'll see how round two goes right after this. Now, since it's 0-0, and Denise went first last time, we'll ask you to go first this time. Rick, A or B?
B.
Okay. Everyone will play again. Jim said, the males are really slow. I just got a draft notice to go fight in the blank war. The males are slow. Okay. Ready? All right. Okay, Rick, here we go. Jim said the males are really slow. I just got a draft notice to go fight in the blank war.
The Civil War?
Civil War? What is the war of your choice?
Well, it's called Pick a War.
Pick a War, that's
I've
exactly.
I've been quite uncivil myself.
Civil, yeah. Okay.
Speak softly and carry a big stick. Spanish American.
Spanish American war, right. Thank you, Teddy Roosevelt.
That was a war.
That was
it's
a war.
The war of your choice.
That was
the right.
war.
No need for booing.
It's an older war.
Go
than...
on, my dear.
If you dare.
Civil.
Okay. Well, that's two of those. One Spanish American, one civil. I just got a draft notice to go fight in the Civil War. What do you say to that?
Civil
War. Civil War. What is the war of your choice, Bill?
Was there a Polish War? No, there was no Polish War. I'm sorry, I'm not very civil, so I got the Spanish War.
The Spanish War.
Sorry.
Sorry.
I apologize. I'm sorry.
Three civils and two Spanish. Nobody said World War II, which was a long time ago. What have you got?
The Boer War.
The Boer War. It was about the time of the Civil War, wasn't it? What year was the Boer War? 1900.
I don't remember. It was so boring.
Okay. Nothing is beneath you, Bill Daly.
Ready. All right. Denise, this is yours. Listen carefully. In Venice, Italy.
Yeah.
The cop said, "Things are different here with all these canals. Instead of streetwalkers, we got street blankers." The policeman in Venice, Italy is speaking. Okay, Denise, here we go. In Venice, Italy, the cop said, "Things are different here with all these canals. Instead of streetwalkers, we got street blankers."
Floaters?
Floaters. Street floaters, eh? Okay, she said street floaters, darn.
This is a truly boring answer, but it just seemed like street swimmers to me.
Street swimmers, yeah. All right.
Now, this could be a match, you see, because when you swim, you also float. Now, both of these could be...
Nice try. Goodbye.
The judges are so bloody mean.
Yes, they are.
Swimmers.
So we have three swimmers up there. I guess swimmers would be a little more logical since we did say walkers versus what else here?
Well, no, it's I'm going the same way, but I want to know how they get their work done. I don't want to know.
I just said float on their back. There. Yeah. What do you say, Bill?
That's why she said floaters.
Yes.
If you've seen the water in Venice, you can't walk on it, by the way.
That's right, you can't. Very bad stuff.
Yes, I said swimmers, too, because I can swim in that muck.
Five of those, yep.
Five swimmers.
Okay, don't expect six here.
Now, this is going to be a problem.
Why?
Well, I said swimmers, also known as floaties of the night.
Aha! Oh. Floaties! Okay, go to round three here.
Floaties of the night.
Thank you. Oh, Fred Waring is whirling.
All right, Rick, since you're still ahead, we're going to ask you to go first again, A or B?
A, please.
A. Got it. A. Nervous Ned is really nervous.
How nervous is he?
I'll tell you how nervous he is. He's like Pinocchio at a blank convention.
Gotcha, baby. Gotcha.
Nervous Ned is really nervous. He's like Pinocchio at a blank convention. All right. Here we go, Rick. Nervous Ned is really nervous. He's like Pinocchio at a blank convention.
Plastic surgeon?
You know who Pinocchio is?
One with a nose.
Yeah, and what was he made out of?
Wood.
Yes. Right. Does that tell you anything now?
Carpenter.
Oh, I get it! Oh!
Too late.
Oh, too late.
Too late.
Oh, that was so simple. It's wood and I got it.
All right.
You think living that close to the water has done this,
James? Yes. What have you got?
Maybe it's just anticipating a new marriage or something. You suppose that's what it is, hon?
Yes, don't you? Has he committed himself?
Yes, he certainly has. Oh, Rick, I said carpenters.
Carpenters is a good answer, yeah.
And I don't know.
Carpenters convention. What's old Bill Daly got there?
He doesn't want to tell you.
You saw it, right?
You say termites.
I put a nose pickers convention.
Yeah.
There's a wooden nose picker.
If you had your druthers, you would have said termite, right?
Termite coming. Yeah, I'm sorry.
But carpenters, termites, all those are good responses, right?
Right. Beaver.
Beaver. Yeah. See, they would have started biting your knee, and pretty soon the beaver, when he bit through your knees, yelled, "Timber!" Thank you. Okay. Now, where are we here? Listen, Denise, here's the way it is. You need two to tie and three to win. This is your last shot at it. Tom said, We have an antique icebox. I know it's antique because when I open it, instead of a light bulb, a blank comes on. Antique icebox. I know it's antique because when I open the door, instead of a light bulb, a blank comes on. Okay, Denise, Tom said we have an antique icebox. I know it's antique because when I open it, instead of a light bulb, a blank comes on.
A candle?
A candle. All right, let's see.
You can say
I'll give you a buck and a half for the best.
A buck and a half?
Buck and a half.
You got it.
Okay. I'll take a buck and a half for mine.
All right. What have you got? I know it's antique, but when you open it, instead of a light bulb, a blank comes on.
Jack be nimble, Jack be quick.
A candle. Okay, it's going now 3-2. Brett?
Okie doke.
Yeah.
Don't curse the darkness, light a candle.
Right. Door is tied 3-3. One more. Candle wins the game. Candle wins the game. We're going to say goodbye to Rick Yoder. We thank you for being here. Some gifts to your way from Match Game PM. Rick Yoder, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you.
All right, we'll spin them off and spin a message for you. Here we go. That's fine. Big Bunny Super Match coming up here for you, Denise. And you can win a really big bundle here, over $20,000 if you get lucky and skillful. And to do that, we got two audience matches for you. Here we go with the first one. We polled the studio audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Jean Blank. That's J-E-A-N Blank. I don't spell my name that way. You get $500 for matching their most popular answer, $250 for the second most popular, and $100 for the third. Whom do you call on here?
Charles.
Jean Harlow.
Jean Harlow.
Brett.
A wonderful actress, Jean Simmons.
Yes, indeed.
Don.
Don.
Jean Rayburn.
Jean Rayburn.
No. It'll be there.
No, it won't be there.
Yes,
did
it
you
will.
See?
How can you tell?
Because they can't spell.
Because they see. Oh.
What do you say, Don? Moving on to a completely different subject, let's try Jeanne d'Arc.
Jeanne d'Arc. Okay.
Thanks, Don.
There's Jeanne d'Arc. And Jean Harlow and Jean Simmons. You want one of those?
I'll take Jean Harlow.
Jean Harlow. All right, let's go down and see what we got under the $100 number. Jean the Music Machine. Okay. Let's see what we got under the next one. Jean Stable and another wonderful actress. Yes, indeed. Last chance for Jean Harlow. Here we go. Yeah! Okay, I got 500 means at least you'll play for us 10 times that amount or 5,000, but now we're going to see how much more money you'll win with your second audience match. Kinky Blank. Okay, here we go. Who do you want?
Charles.
You got me, hon.
Kinky.
Kinky.
Like.
Get out the kinky.
Whatever you think, Charles.
What if I say and we go off the air?
Well, that's right. But we're on videotape. So don't worry about it.
Videotape. No.
Kinky videotape.
Kinky
no.
sex.
Kinky
I read
sex.
About it.
Yeah. You read about it once? Sure you did.
Brett?
Kinky hair?
Kinky hair.
Kinky hair. Don?
Anybody got any?
Kinky curlers.
What's the topic?
Kinky dinky do.
Kinky D band. Just get
Kinky D band.
Go
the Kinky D band.
Whatever
they
that
played at Joan of Arc's. Yeah.
Kinky D band, kinky hair, and kinky sex. You want one of those, or have you got one a better one for us?
I thought of Kinky D, but I think I'm going to go with kinky sex.
Yeah.
Kinky sex. Okay, let's see what you got in the $100 number. Any kinky sex there? Kinky dinky. Yeah. Kinky dinky. Oh, we want kinky sex. Let's see the next one, please. We got it. All right.
What's under the big one?
Hair.
Hair. Hair. Yeah, kinky hair. Now you want another dollar 250 times 10 is 2,500. Added to the previous 5,000 gives you 7,500 to shoot for. However, we're going to ask you to spin the wheel now, and you can double your money and play for $15,000. We'll all root for a double. Here we go. Good luck. Yes, sirree. Any gold star area would be a double. Not quite. Okay, good luck to you. You're going to be playing with Brett there, a good player, and this is it. Blank, no evil. Blank, no evil. Put it in the slot, Brett, and away we go. Okay, Denise, give us the answer that she's got on the card. If you do, you get $7,500. What do you say? Blank, no evil.
C.
C, no evil. That sounds reasonable to me. Brett, she says C, no evil will match you. What do you say?
There were three.
There were three. See no evil, hear no evil, and...
And speak no evil. You know, I'm so verbal. Oh, C!
We're all very happy for this lady. Join us next week when we hope to give away another bundle, another group of wonderful stars like these here on Match Game PM. Gene Rayburn, goodbye.
Some contestants will receive the Bearcat Alert Warning Radio. Turns on automatically when the National Weather Service broadcasts tornado, flood, or severe weather warnings. Don't stay home without it. And a Master Mechanic 8 Gallery. Pennzoil helps keep your car free from slow starts, bucking, and stalling. Gum out the between tune-ups, tune-up. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game PM, a Mark Goodson, Bill Trotman production.